A production of Kentucky State University Aquaculture.
Yesterday, 9 p.m., we gave to females resolving conjection. So expected time of ovulation about 8 a.m. So we came here and we see that on the bottom already there are eggs. So some female already ready. But there is maybe variability. The time of eggs ovulation may be different in different females. So now we put individual females in harpers and check them. And female which are ready to strip eggs, we put in anesthetic. In order to check female, no need to remove fish from out of the water. It's enough to turn female and to press on abdomen. And it's possible if female is ready, eggs will flow out from genital port. Okay? This female is ready to be stripped. You see? Eggs flowing. So now I put it in an anesthetic. We selected here several females which are ready to be stripped. Now we'll strip eggs from several koi females. Ghost female, excess of water. Put here. Now it's very important to wipe out all water. This is red female. It's okay. So when female is ready, you can see that eggs, they flow freely. I press abdomen a little bit, but... That's it. So you see how injection works. So we injected yesterday resolving dosage 9 p.m. Today 8, they are ready. It's sometimes not only in this part, but in front part also. Oh, you see? Now it's done. Okay, now you can put a little vertical a little bit and put this way here. No, this way and kind of to massage.
Okay.
And after that to try maybe from the front part.
The front.
Here. You see?
Yeah.
Oh, that's it. Now we sign of blood, it's been, that's it. And you can see here a large female, you see empty, nothing. Instead of big belly, We already collected eggs from all females. Now we will collect sperm from males. The same as females, we put fish in anesthetic, and now they are ready to be stripped.
To put.
Usually last portion of sperm is also with small amount of blood, which means it's already finished for this male.
Wild carpet.
No, need more?
Okay, it's triple. Okay, good.
Oh, you see? Now we perform artificial fertilization of eggs. So, you see here eggs, 250 grams. So now I add sperm. Actually, in this case, sperm a little diluted, so I put maybe more than needed. From this male, it was special cross, and this male was very diluted sperm. Okay, now I mix eggs and sperm. And as I said in lecture, currently nothing happened. I mean, because eggs not activated without water, and sperm is not activated without water. This is simply mechanical mixing. So now we add water. No, it's from the beginning it's better to use water and only after that milk solution to prevent clumping, to prevent adhesiveness. So now I will start and will be actually activation of eggs and sperm. After 2 minutes, I will add, maybe add a little more water, and after 2 minutes, I will start adding milk. This is 1.5, 2 minutes, it's not kind of, because I saw that eggs start clumping. So this is the main procedure, so now it's easy. And actually milk now is commonly used for common carp. Before you used tannic acid and
other stuff, but milk works pretty good. So now, as I explained in lecture, in this moment, activation of eggs and sperm, so spermatozoa penetrate to the eggs, in eggs cortical reaction and formation perivitellin space. We don't see this, but we know it's happened now. So actually, before putting to McDonald's jars, around 45 minutes, 1 hour. Because, no, actually, it's need to prevent eggs clumping in, so, but actually this will be, I will now let somebody do it, and I will, you add milk, and I will make another cross, okay? So after adding water, it needs simply time to stir eggs in milk solution to prevent adhesiveness and formation of clumps. And you can see here that after about half hour after insemination, you can see that already no clumps, and you can see here separate eggs. In another 20-30 minutes, we put eggs in McDonald's jar. Now, after about 1 hour after insemination, eggs are ready to be put in McDonald's jar for further incubation. Okay, now, okay, Russell, okay. Now, for water here. Here we have sometimes bubbles go, because we heat water in closed condition. There is sometimes water contain bubbles of air, and when bubbles attach to eggs actually they start heating out from McDonald's jar. So therefore, we put heavy on the ring to prevent. And now you can see that already eggs are not adhesive, and you can see separate eggs.